I think perhaps the greatest challenge that wilderness faces in the future is us, humans. And so, you know, for better or worse, I think the questions that we begin to ask ourselves, and then more importantly, the answers to those questions, will dictate what happens to wilderness in the future. So, for example, you know, will this wilderness ideology persevere into the future? Questions like, will people continue to see its value? Can we alter our behavior significantly, being less consumptive, being more conscientious, so that we can coexist, and not just for the next 10 or 20 years or whatever's convenient, but theoretically indefinitely? And so, again, I think we're the biggest challenge to the wilderness, and how we address that and move forward will dictate what happens in the future. So there's a Cree, a Native American prophecy that I think is really relevant. And the gist of it is that only when the last tree has been cut down, only when the last river has been poisoned, only when the last fish has been caught, only then will we see that money cannot be eaten. It's an incredibly powerful prophecy, but my hope is that we can learn these lessons before it comes to that, so that before, you know, the last tree falls, before this last fish has been caught, before all of our water has been contaminated, that we can find this lesson. And I think the wilderness is perhaps the best place for us to go and seek that lesson before it's too late.